We want to count the total number of bonds in a molecule, and so therefore that will consist of determining, we're adding up the number of sigma bonds plus the number of pi bonds that a molecule may have right there, right? And so for this right there, what we're going to do is we're going to combine two equations that were previously derived. One of them was it's also designated as a sigma rule right there, which is basically, it's the sum of the atoms plus the rings, okay, minus one right there, right? This is the sigma rule right there, right? I'm going to rewrite this in another form so we can actually figure this out easily. So we'll put carbon, nitrogen, the number of carbons, the carbon, the number of nitrogens, just continue the periodic table right there, right? Halogens, and then we'll even put what hydrogen over here, and then we'll add the term ring. Minus one right there, right? Okay, so that's the sigma rule right there, right? Just to add up all the atoms plus the rings minus one right there, right? Now the equation for the number of pi bonds right there, right? That one we derived by first taking what the sum of, or the equation for what the number of hydrogens, right? Which was what, two plus two carbon plus nitrogen. This equation had the number of hydrogens had oxygen had no bearing in it right there, right? Minus halogens, minus two pi, the pi bonds right there, minus two ring right there, right? Okay, and then what we did with this equation right there is we rearranged it right there, right? So that we would have what's called the index of hydrogen deficiency right there, right? Which was to take the count of number of hydrogens, right? If you had what? This is the count of number of hydrogens. If you had no pi bonds or rings right there, right? Okay, and subtract the number of hydrogens that you actually have, and therefore that's the index of hydrogen deficiency right there, right? And then what we did right there is we took this equation and divide through by two. Whoops, we didn't actually erase it. We just divided through by two right there, right? And when we did that right there, right, then we came up with this equation where the number of rings and pi bonds right there, the sum of them, although we can't distinguish them by this equation right there, is one plus carbon plus half the nitrogens minus half the halogens minus half the hydrogens right there, right? Okay. This we call the cyclomatic formula right there, right? Actually, in the video where we derived this right there, right, I didn't explain the cyclomatic name right there. That's because normally in mathematics right there, people don't have, you know, structures like this where you would have what what's called in graphs right there, right, or pictures right there, right, what we would call what multigraphs, which is that you have things like simulating pi bonds right there. And so, therefore, you would only have a connection or a bond between two atoms right there, right? Or just sigma bonds right there, right? Okay, and so therefore the equation could still be used right there, right, to determine the number of rings right there without what we refer to as pi bonds right there, right? Okay, but don't get distracted by that if you don't understand that part right there, right? That's just some math. Okay, so we did get the cyclomatic formula. Rings plus pi bonds is equal to the formula right there, right? For this formula right there, right? Okay, so now what we can do is we can take this formula and just rearrange it by moving the rings over to the right side. Just some algebra right there, right? Move it over to the right side right there, right? And now we have all that we need right there, right? We have the number of sigma bonds right there, right? And we have the number of pi bonds right there. And so now we can go ahead and calculate sigma plus pi, which would be all the bonds that you have in a molecule right there, right? And so what we'll notice right there, right, is that the first term here and here, that cancels out right there, right? And so therefore, we don't need to write down minus one or one in this. The other thing that cancels out is ring and minus ring right here, okay? If we add up these two equations right there, right, so we don't need that. All we do need to combine now is the terms for the number of elements. So it comes out to be what, 2c plus, if we add this and this together right there, right, that comes out to be 3 halves the number of nitrogens right there, right? If we combine this equation, well, there's no term for oxygen down here, so we just put down oxygen down here. Halogen, how do we combine halogen? Halogen and hydrogen, actually, we combine the same way because they're monovalent right there. And that's starting to give you a hint of what's happening over here. So 1 minus a half is equal to, is just half right there. And the same thing for hydrogens right there, right? Okay. So just like as we've done before right there, we want to come up with, okay, let's come up with simplification. Where do we get these coefficients right there if we have different elements that are not just these valencies are these elements right there, right? Okay. So for that, let's write down the normal valencies right here, right? And then hopefully right away you'll see the pattern of where these coefficients came from. So basically the 2 in front of the carbon is just 4 divided by 2. The 3 halves in front of nitrogen is 3 divided by 2. The 1, the implicit 1 in front of oxygen is basically 2 divided by 2. And the half is 1 divided by 2 and so forth right there, right? So now we can write the normal we can write down the generic formula, which is if you have an element y right there, right? You divide through by its valency by 2 and multiply times the number of y's you have right there. That'll give you its contribution to the total bonds that you have in a molecule, sigma plus pi on there, right? Okay, so we can rewrite this whole equation right there, right, in mathematical terms right there, right, is the sum of, okay, and so we'll write it down here right there, right, of valencies plus what, y right there, right, okay, which is just a fancy way of doing that. Of course, you would have different y's right there, right, and you put an index on here, a little I on here, right, for different elements that you have on here, right, and so now that we see this equation right there, right, the question is, you know, can we understand why, after all, everything right there, right, and after all the equations that I've shown you before right there, why does equation such come up with such simpler terms right there, right, that basically, what this is saying, right, is basically that every element right there, right, whether it's we're going to form sigma or pi bonds right there, right, basically only contributes half the electrons for making the bonds right there, right? That's what this fancy term is saying right there, right? Okay, so for instance, an element like carbon that can form 4 bonds, well, the reason is because, remember, whether you're forming a sigma or pi bond right there, right, you need 2 electrons, or a sigma bond consists of 2 electrons, a pi bond consists of 2 electrons right there, right? And so therefore, if you know the valency right there, right, where each atom only contributes half of the electrons for making the total number of bonds right there, right? Okay. To illustrate this, let's take a picture over here. Let's slip over to here. And so here I have methane right here, right? And so what I'm going to do, hopefully you can see this, is I'm going to go ahead and split these, split the bonds right there, right? Okay. I'm not doing anything to the lone pairs right there, right? But I'm just splitting the bonds right there, so that you will see right there what we're talking about right there, right? So for instance, hydrogen right there is monovalent right there, right? And so therefore, it only contributes for making half a bond, right? That's why 1 divided by 2 right there, right? Oxygen right there, right, is divalent right there, right? And so 2, it only contributes to making 1 bond right there, right? Because it has 2 electrons. And so it helps to make half of this bond and half of this bond right there, right? So, 2 divided by 2 is 1 right there, right? And then carbon over here right there, even though it's tetravalent right there around, well, it only, 4 divided by 2, it only really contributes to making what? The number of electrons that it's donating right there for making bonds, which is 4 right there, could only really be used to make what? 2 bonds right there, right? Whether they be sigma or pi bonds right there, right? Okay. So therefore, we come up with this very simplified form right there, right, that the total number of sigma and pi bonds, or total number of bonds in a molecule, is basically the contribution of what half of the valency of each one of the atoms that you have in there, right? And so therefore, it varies from carbon to nitrogen or oxygen, Or if you have another element with a different valency right there, right? You can now deal with it right there, right? And again, besides the fact that it's showing all these equations, we're trying to show you how systematic organic chemistry is right there, right? If you understand organic chemistry from the structures right there, right? Then organic chemistry is very systematic right there, right? The only difficulties are in organic chemistry is basically nomenclature right there, right? Very artificial. The nomenclature is not natural, and so therefore you have to memorize things. But in terms of figuring out things like the total number of bonds right there, right? Well, it's all very mathematical, very systematic right there, okay? And you could also use this to determine, well, if I bought a model set, and I have, the monovalent piece and the piece that can, divalent that can connect to two things and so forth, did they sell me the right number of tubes right there, right? To be able to attach and make my model set. You know, a model set that sort of looks like this right there, right? Of course, with not all the disconnected pieces, and you have what, a trigonal, tetrahedral, and linear pieces right there to put your things, to put things together, okay? So there you have it. The total number of bonds is what? Is half the valency of each one of the contributing atoms right there, whether they be sigma or pi bonds.